Welcome, riding buddies. Very special video today. We're taking a quick look at the round two of the 2020 Sunshine State Motocross Series. This was held at Kingaroy, so sit back and we'll have a bit of a run through and see what happened up there. So the first class that we'll have a look at today was the 50cc Auto 7 to 9 year olds. To take out third place, Ethan Wolf went third, third, third for the day. Nice consistent placings. Second place went to Clayton Walsh with a second, second and a first to really make an upset. First place was Nathan Perrott going 1, 1 and a 2. The 65cc 7 to 9 years had a lot of very consistent riders through the weekend. Bodie Court came out third with a consistent third all day. Sonny Constantine took out second spot, once again with a consistent second all day. But Kyle Harvey had everyone's measure, taking out the day with a first place in all three motos. The 65cc 10 to 11 years was a little bit of a mixed bag out the front. Lachlan Grant coming in third with a first, third and a third. Joshua Searle coming in second with a nice consistent 2-2-2 all day. Jackson Fuller, once again, a mixed up result with a third and a first and a first to come out first place. The Mini Lights, or 85cc as they were formerly known, 9 to 11 years was a real mixed up bag of results. Luke Constantine took out third spot with a fifth, a third, and a second. Max Stevenson took out second spot with second, second, and a third. Heath Fisher was the real consistent runner of the weekend with a 1-1-1 taking out first spot. Mini Lights 12 to 15 years, Riley Fitzpatrick went 2-3-3 for third for the weekend. Braden Plath went a 4-1-1 going second for the weekend, and Byron Dennis showing that consistency wins with a 1-2-2. The Junior Lights two-stroke 13 to 15 years. Byron Dennis went 4-2-3 for a third. Jack Mather went a 2-4-2 for second. Ryan Alexanderson proved consistency with 1-1-1 to take outright win. The Junior Lights four-stroke 13 to 15 years went with Jack Mather with third with a 4-2-2. Kobe Wolf second outright for a 1-3-4. And Ryan Alexanderson took out the overall with a second, a first and a first. The women showed consistency for the whole weekend with Brioni Hendrickson going 3-3-3 for third outright. Alicia Goulet going 2-2-2 for second outright, and Talia Drew dominating the class with a 1-1-1 for first outright. The vets came out and had a wobble around with Andrew Gifford going 3-3-3 for third, Travis Regling going 2-2-2 for second, Chris Nichols going 1-1-1 for a dominant weekend. MX2 clubmen were a real mix of results. Jaden Purdy going 3-7-1 for third outright. Joshua Brown going 1-4-3 for second. Matthew Spence going 2-2-2, proving it was consistent to get the results. The MX2 experts came out with confusion on their minds. Logan May going 8-2-3 for third. Jake Cowell going 2-5-4 for second, and the consistent Levi Rogers going 1-1-1 for first. The MX2 Pros was an absolute corker of a race. Jay Wilson going 7-2-1 for third place, Noah Ferguson going 1-3-3 for second, and Aaron Tanti going 2-1-2 for a very tight first. MX1 Clubman had Cam Watson going 3-3-2 for third outright. Jaden Summers for a 2-2-1 for second. And Joshua Brown 1-1-3 for first. MX1 experts were a real mixed bag as well. Nicholas Kefford, lucky to hold on to third spot with a 2-18-2. Cody O'Lone, going great guns with a 3-2-1 for second spot. Lawson Preston, going 1-1-3 for first place. Our final class, the MX1 Pros. Reese Budd, going 4-4-3 for third. Lockie Latimer going 2-2-2 for a nice consistent second spot. Dean Ferris with a very dominant 1-1-1 for first outright for the weekend. Overall, it was an absolutely awesome weekend up at Kingaroy. The club put on an absolutely fantastic track. It got very deep ruts on the Sunday, but then again, we do have the pros on the Sunday as well. So they absolutely enjoyed it. The biggest highlight for me for the weekend would have to have been the battle between Aaron Tandy and Noah Ferguson, fighting over first place. Unfortunately, it all came unstuck for the two riders, allowing Jay Wilson to take the win in that moto. Big thank you has to go out to the club for hosting the event. They put on an absolutely fantastic weekend. Special thank you to all the organisers, all the officials and everybody that helped out over the weekend. Of course, also to a special thank you to all the riders for coming along and a really big special thank you to all our sponsors. Of course, thank you for watching this video. If you've enjoyed what you've seen, have a look through my library of other videos that I've been doing. Also too, I will be trying to cover some more events as we go along. There's also a lot of variations of different videos that I've been doing. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and we'll catch you next time.